Hit him.
Hit him hard.
Do what he says. Now, and in a hurry. And from now on, when he tells you to do something, do it. Don't think about it, just obey. You understand me?
Would you do the same thing if another child were born to you, feet first?
Yes. Yes. It would be my duty.
What in the name of Almighty God are we trying to do to these people?
That man's an accomplice to murder. Even he's admitted that.
But can we make him understand it? We take away their customs, their habits, their religion. We stop their tribal dances. We stop them circumcising their women. Then we offer them our way of life, something they can't grasp. We say, look how clean and rich and clever we are. With the Africans. Different wages, different life.
In Nairobi, capital of Kenya, Europeans and Africans still walk the streets in fear of a dreaded Mau Mau. For it is that band of fanatics whose bloody deeds have cast a dark shadow across the face of Kenya. A week ago, the people of Kenya read of the death of Chief Nderi, murdered by terrorists. And now, as they watch the funeral of this wise and peaceful chieftain, they wonder where next will the Mau Mau strike.
The whole colored world burns with a fever of revolt. You were educated in white missionary schools?
Yes, sir.
Jana Kikuyu?
Yes, sir.
And have the British ever become Kikuyus? Or have you become one of the British?
Your father was a friend of the British. But your father died in their prison.
There is only one way to drive out the British. By terror and death.
Everyone must either be for us or against us. Those who be with us, stand.
Not only fanatics fill the ranks of the Mau Mau. Many have joined from fear.
You will swear a new blood oath. When it is done, you will be part of the new army, Mau Mau. He who refuses to take the oath, dies. He who breaks the oath, he dies.
It's my fight too. But Mau Mau has killed 100 of my people for every one of yours. I want the same thing for the African that Kimani wants. Mau Mau is not the way to get them.
What's happened to us? When did this hatred begin?
Not a question of black or white. That's exactly what it is, black or white.
They were fighting against a colonial power, an imperialist power, a vulturous society. And this vulturous society, with its control of the press and its allies here in the United States, who also control much of the press, projected these freedom fighters, these African patriots, in the image of savages, cannibals, terrorists, as criminals, actually.
A state of emergency now exists in Kenya. Kikuyus are being sworn into a terror organization called Mau Mau. Small gangs are fighting guerrilla warfare. There may be Mau Mau on your farms, in your cities, in your homes. Any African found with a gun may be punished by death.
So it's prisoners we're after. And it's your job to track them down and bring them in.
I say kill them. Make it open warfare. Bomb them out.
Kill who? All 6 million Africans in Kenya?
And we're only 40,000. That makes the odds about 150 to 1.
That's not the point. We're not at war with the Kikuyu nation. We're fighting Mau Mau. For every one of us, they've killed 100 Kikuyu. Loyal Kikuyu.
They don't know what loyalty means.
How do you Mau Mau do it?
Since when do we use torture?
The Mau Mau do it. They love it.
You might even grow to love it yourself.
Well, I don't like it any more than you do. But I don't like what happened to Madsen's wife either. Or your family or any families to come.
We're not such a big jump away from being savages ourselves, are we?
Please let me point him out from here. Please let me.
This is the man. Your name?
Njogu.
Is he the one? Is he the oath giver? You said his name was Njogu. You said he was here.
Do not let me stay. Do not let me stay here! You promised!
Where is your friend?
You there! All of you! Put down your guns!